Hello everyone, I am Ravi P. Singh from Department of Chemistry, IIT Delhi. I am going to discuss about the biomolecules. In this unit, we are going to talk about different kind of biomolecules such as carbohydrates, proteins and nucleic acid. We are going to classify carbohydrates, protein, nucleic acid and vitamins based on their structures, and we are going to learn about differences between the DNA and RNA. These are the nucleic acid, and we are also going to appreciate the role of biomolecules in the system. So first let's talk about the biomolecules. Biomolecules are organic compound found in living system, or we can say that living systems are built up of various complex biomolecules such as carbohydrates, proteins, nucleic acid, lipids, etc. Particularly, carbohydrates and proteins are essential constituent of our food. And their interaction constitute logic of life processes. Carbohydrates serve as a major source of metabolic energy. Now, so before discussing about carbohydrates, let's talk about that, you know, what are carbohydrates chemically? What is the question here? What are carbohydrates? Carbohydrates are usually defined as polyhydroxyaldehydes, aldehydes or ketones. Polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones are the compounds that yield after the hydrolysis polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketones. So again, I will like to rephrase it, the definition of carbohydrate. Carbohydrates are usually defined as polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones are the compound after hydrolysis generates polyhydroxyaldehydes and ketones. The chemical structure of carbohydrates are commonly represented by Fischer projection formulae. Here I will show you two examples of carbohydrates. First one is glucose, and the second one is fructose. Both these glucose and fructose have the molecular formula C6H12O6. Consistent with the journal formula C6H2O6. That made early chemists think that basically carbohydrates are hydrates of carbon. Hydrates of carbon. Now let's look over the, you know, these structures, Fischer projection D glucose and D fructose. So here I'm going to draw the Fischer projection structure of D glucose. Here you can see that this molecule has four chiral center. And it has aldehyde in its framework. This is Fischer projection formula of D glucose. Now I will draw Fischer projection formula of D fructose. This is D fructose. If you look over these two compounds, one is D glucose is polyhydroxyaldehyde, and D fructose is polyhydroxyketone. Now, I will talk about the classification of carbohydrates. Classification of carbohydrates. The term carbohydrates or saccharide or sugar are interchangeably used, and saccharide comes from our early language. If you look over in Sanskrit, it is known as sarkara in Sanskrit. And saccharon in Greek. Saccharon in Greek and saccharum in Latin. So, term carbohydrates or saccharides or sugars, which are used interchangeably, has been derived from our ancient languages. As I mentioned that in Sanskrit, it is known as sarkara, in Greek, it is known as saccharon, and in Latin, it is known as saccharum. We can classify it into two parts. First one is simple carbohydrates. Simple carbohydrates. Simple carbohydrates are monosaccharides. Simple carbohydrates are monosaccharide. and they can be also called as single sugar. Single sugar. Second one is complex carbohydrate. Complex carbohydrates contain two or more monosaccharide. Contain two or more monosaccharide. Monosaccharides which are linked together. Now, these complex carbohydrates can be further subdivided into three parts. First one is disaccharides. Disaccharides which contain two monosaccharide, contains two monosaccharides. Second one is oligosaccharide. Oligosaccharide contains 3 to 10 monosaccharides. 3 to 10 monosaccharide. Monosaccharides. And the last one is polysaccharide. Polysaccharide which contains more than 10, more than 10 monosaccharide units. So, here we subdivided complex carbohydrates based on the number of monosaccharides in three subdivision: disaccharide, oligosaccharide and polysaccharide. Disaccharides contains 2 monosaccharides, oligosaccharide contains 3 to 10 monosaccharides and polysaccharide contains more than 10 monosaccharides which are linked with each other. To make you understand in a better way, I will like to write here a schematic representation where various monosaccharides are linked with each other, and this is getting hydrolyzed. After the hydrolysis, it will generate many monosaccharide units. Here, in this polysaccharide, M is a monosaccharide unit. Monosaccharide unit, it's a subunit, I can say. And here after the hydrolysis, it generates number of monosaccharides. This molecule is polysaccharide. So, a polysaccharide where number of monosaccharide subunits are linked with each other is getting hydrolyzed, and that generates that many number of monosaccharide after the hydrolysis. Now, I will like to classify monosaccharides, that what are monosaccharides. Let's talk about classification of monosaccharide. classification of monosaccharide. It can be classified in two ways, based on the number of carbon atom present in the molecule. Carbon atoms present in the molecule. Second, whether they contain an aldehyde or keto group. So, two things we have to remember regarding the classification of monosaccharides. It can be classified based on the number of carbon atoms in the molecule, and the second thing that it has an aldehyde or keto group. These are the two factors. Thus, let's take example. Thus, a monosaccharide containing 3 carbon atom with 3 carbon atom is called as triose. Triose. Tri stand for 3 and O's stand for the sugar. 3 carbon atoms, triose. If it has 4 carbon atom, one molecule contains 4 carbon atom, then it is called tetrose. Please remember, tet stands for the 4. O's stand for the sugar. If it has 3 carbon atoms, then triose. If it has 4 carbon atom, tetrose. And if it has 5 carbon atom, then it is called pentose. Similarly, it can go to hexose, heptose, etc. Now, a monosaccharide containing an aldehyde group, is called aldose. Aldehyde group is called aldose, whereas a monosaccharide containing a keto group is called ketose. Now, it is clear that we have classified monosaccharide based on two criteria. If a monosaccharide is having 3 carbon atoms, then it is called triose. If a monosaccharide is having 4 carbon atoms, then it is called tetrose. Similarly, 5 carbon atoms, then pentose, and 6 and 7, then hexose and heptose, etc. The another criteria is based on the functional group. If it has aldehyde functional group in its framework, then it is called aldose, whereas if it has ketone in its functional group, in its framework, then it is called ketose. These two classifications are frequently combined. A C4 aldose, for example, is called aldotetrose. Aldo stand for the aldehyde, aldotetrose, aldotetrose. Similarly, a C5 ketose is called keto pentose. Now, I will show you few examples of these aldose and ketose to make you understand in a better way. So, let us take, you know, structure of an aldose. As I mentioned, aldose will have an aldehyde group, and according to definition, it will also have polyhydroxy framework. So, to represent it, I am making this structure. This is an aldose. For ketose, we need to have a ketone group and polyhydroxy framework, which I am denoting by this structure. This is a ketose. Now, I will take an specific example such as an aldo tetrose. In aldo tetrose, as I mentioned, it will have an aldehyde group as well as it will have 4 carbon numbers, because while discussing the classification of monosaccharide, we were focusing on 2 things. One is the number of carbon atoms, and the other thing is the type of functional group. Does it have aldehyde or ketone? So, here I am taking example of aldo tetrose. So, aldo means it has aldehyde, and tetrose means it has 4 carbon atoms. So, an aldo tetrose. It has C4. Similarly, I will take from ketose group. Keto pentose. Keto pentose means that it has like ketone in its framework and polyhydroxy framework. And since it is keto pentose, it has like, you know, 5 carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, this is a keto pentose. Keto pentose, it is C5. Now, we will take some practice problem that, you know, how many chirality centers are there in aldo tetrose and in keto pentose. So, let us take a look on the structure of aldo tetrose. If you look over, in the case of aldo tetrose, we have 2 chiral center, 1 and 2. Similarly, in the case of a keto pentose, it has 2 chiral center, 1 and 2. Another problem we can think, that how many stereoisomers are possible for these 2 monosaccharide, for aldo tetrose and for keto pentose. So, as we know that it depends on the number of chiral center, and since it has like 2 chiral center, so 4 stereoisomers for both the molecules are possible. Now, I will talk about DL designation of monosaccharide. DL designation of monosaccharide. The simplest monosaccharide are the glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone. The simplest monosaccharides are compounds glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone. Let me draw the structure of glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone. Glyceraldehyde has one chiral center and one aldehyde group in its scaffold, whereas dihydroxyacetone has two hydroxyl group and one ketone group in its scaffold. And based on the nomenclature, we can tell them basically glyceraldehyde is an aldotriose . Why it is aldotriose? Because it has aldehyde group and it has three carbon in its scaffold. And this dihydroxyacetone is a ketotriose. Now, because of the three carbon atoms and similar way ketone group, we have named it ketotriose. Of these two compounds, only glyceraldehyde contains a chirality center. You can see here, only glyceraldehyde has one chiral center, whereas dihydroxyacetone does not have any chiral center. Therefore, glyceraldehyde exists in the enantiomeric forms, and that are known to be, based on their absolute configuration, R glyceraldehyde and S glyceraldehyde. I will discuss in detail. First, I will like to write their structure. So, based on the absolute configuration, the two glyceraldehydes are possible because it has one chiral center. First one is where the aldehyde group, it attaches to the carbon and hydroxyl group and hydrogen. So, this is the carbon which is a chiral, with which you can see here one aldehyde group and CH2OH is attached and one hydroxyl and hydrogen is attached. This is plus glyceraldehyde. Another example is where now this is minus glyceraldehyde. In plus glyceraldehyde, what is important here, that hydroxyl is right side, whereas in the minus glyceraldehyde, hydroxyl is at the left side. This is the basic difference between the plus and minus glyceraldehyde. For absolute configuration, I will like to remind you that Kahn-Ingold-Prelog convention generally plus glyceraldehyde plus glyceraldehyde is known as R plus glyceraldehyde. Whereas minus glyceraldehyde is S minus glyceraldehyde. Now, this nomenclature is based on the, you know, absolute configuration, and before this nomenclature came in practice, which is based on the absolute configuration, there was another system which was introduced in 1906, by M. A. Rosenhoff, which is known as DL system. In DL system, plus glyceraldehyde is known as D plus glyceraldehyde. Whereas minus glyceraldehyde is known as L minus glyceraldehyde. These two compounds, moreover, serve as configurational standards for the rest of the sugar molecules, or you can say that for the monosaccharide. A monosaccharide which highest chirality center is having some configuration similar to the D plus glyceraldehyde is known as the D sugar, or if it has the configuration similar to the L glyceraldehyde, then it is known as L sugar. Now I will explain it with the example, these two. So one whose highest number chirality center has the same configuration as the, you know, D, it is called the D sugar, D glyceraldehyde with the D glyceraldehyde, and is called the D sugar. One with the having absolute configuration similar to the L glyceraldehyde is called L sugar. Let me write here the structure of these two sugars. So first I will write the structure of aldose, a D-aldo pentose. As I mentioned that aldose, so it has to have aldehyde in its scaffold, and then now you see that it has highest chirality center. This is the highest chirality center. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is the 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is 4 the highest chirality center, and this is 5. This is a D-aldo pentose. Another example of ketose is an L ketohexose here again, since it is ketohexose, it has to have ketone group in its scaffold. And finally, the carbon, the last chirality center containing carbon. Now, here these two, these are the highest numbered chirality center. Sorry. Highest numbered chirality center. Highest numbered chirality center. Now let's compare it with the D glyceraldehyde and L glyceraldehyde. If you look over, in the case of D glyceraldehyde, it has resemblance with the D glyceraldehyde, that highest numbered chirality center. So, that is why it is called D-eldopentose, whereas in the ketose case, it is similar to L-glyceraldehyde, hence it is called L-ketohexose. L-ketohexose. Now, I would like to discuss some of the practice problem. Classify the following monosaccharides. Here I am writing some monosaccharide, and based on their absolute configuration, based on their configuration of highest numbered chirality center, you have to classify them. So, let me draw the Fischer projection formula of these example. This is one. Another one is having the ketone group, so if we name it without the configuration, we can say that this first example is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon. So, it becomes eldopentose and aldehyde group. So, it becomes eldopentose. The second example has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 carbon atoms. So, it becomes and ketone group in its scaffold. So, it becomes ketoheptose. And the third example which I want to introduce is eldohexose. Now, since we have to classify these monosaccharides based on the DL designation, let us look over the structure. and look over the highest numbered chirality center in all these cases. Let's take first example. In this example, the highest numbered chirality center has configuration similar to the D-glyceraldehyde. So, it becomes D. Then in second example, again, it has configuration similar to the D-glyceraldehyde. So, it becomes D. And similarly, in the third also, it has configuration similar to the D-glyceraldehyde. So, it becomes D. Now, I will give you some more example to classify the monosaccharide based on the configuration of highest numbered chirality center. Indicate whether each of the following these glyceraldehydes are D or L glyceraldehydes. Let me take the practice problem of glyceraldehyde, and we will identify that it has D or L configuration. So, here I am drawing the glyceraldehyde. Now, we need to identify that it is D or L glyceraldehyde. You would have learned in your stereochemistry class that one interchange of the substituent on a symmetric carbon atom leads to the enantiomer, whereas the two interchange of the substituent leads to the same molecule. So, here what I am going to do that before comparing with the D or L glyceraldehyde, I will do two interchange. First interchange will lead to hydroxyl group left hand side, and second interchange will lead to exchange between the hydrogen and hydroxymethyl group. Now, let us compare it with D-glyceraldehyde, D-glyceraldehyde and L-glyceraldehyde. Now, I am bringing again back that, you know, the highest membered chirality center, when it is similar to the D, then it is called D-glyceraldehyde, and when it is similar to the L-glyceraldehyde, then it is called L-sugar. Here in this case, it is similar to the L, as hydroxyl is in left side. So, it becomes L glyceraldehyde. Now, I will take another example. Again, we will do that two interchange, because two interchange will give the similar compound. So, let me first write it in the three dimensional form. Now, the first interchange will take place between the hydroxyl and CH2OH group. Sorry, first interchange will take place between the hydrogen and aldehyde group. So, And second interchange will take place between the hydrogen and hydroxymethyl group. So it becomes hydroxyl here and hydrogen, and then now let's compare it with the D and L glyceraldehyde. Since hydroxyl group in this part is left hand side, so it becomes L glyceraldehyde. Now, I will like to talk about the configuration of aldoses. Aldotetras have two asymmetric centers, therefore, four stereoisomers are possible, whereas aldopentose has three stereo centers, hence, eight stereoisomers are possible, whereas the aldohexose has four stereo centers, hence, 16 stereoisomers are possible. So, all these stereoisomers are possible based on the number of chiral centers available in the scaffolds. I will like to stop here, and in the next class, I am going to talk about the possible aldohexoses, possible aldopentoses, and possible aldotetroses. Thank you very much.